I'm Rachel Riley. How are you over there?
I'm okay. Yeah. It is like having weird new people in my living room. So we don't normally have as many people in here, and you're there, and it's like I've gone to sleep, and this is all a dream. It's quite a nice one.
If this was, you would not be wearing that. And in charge of numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Rachel Riley is the sexiest mathematician in the world, which sounds impressive until you find out number two is Stephen Hawking. Rachel Riley is as clever as she is beautiful, but then again, so is Sean Locke. And of course, in charge of numbers is Rachel Riley. Striking good looks, blonde hair and tight mini dresses, it's safe to say that Rachel's probably killed off more old men than a winter cold snap. In charge of the numbers tonight, it's Rachel Riley. Since joining Countdown, Rachel Riley has completely revolutionised the way that old men watch the show with a pillow on their lap. We do look a little bit as if we're getting married this evening, I think.
I thought that was a gag, Jimmy. So,
in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. If Rachel Riley's so good at maths, how come whenever I ask her, she can't even remember her own telephone number? Countdown host Nick Hewer recently described Rachel as sharp as a whip. He went on to say she's clever as a corset and as gifted as a gimp mask. It's almost as if he had something else on his mind. Rachel, who do you think is going to excel today?
Well, I've looked at the stats and what I discovered was that John and Miles is an anagram of ninja models. And Rod and Sean together makes hard ones and sore hand. Question, but if they've been practicing, it's not Countdown.
Rachel is also a presenter on Channel 5's The Gadget Show, which I was disappointed to find was just her testing headphones and stuff. Rachel, any tips for the contestants this evening?
Well, based on the last few attempts, it's just very important that the words are real ones.
Rachel Riley, she's hotter and cleverer than Stephen Hawking on a sunbed. Rachel, have you got any advice for tonight's competitors?
Just, you know, stay cool. I know you're pretty nervous about this, but a contestant actually won 3 points with a three-letter word once, so, you know, even if you're rubbish, you'll get down there with like, a two-letter word.
I love how you set the bar, because there's two northerners on, two journeys on.
Well, you know, at is a word.
Rachel is appearing on this year's Strictly Come Dancing. TV bosses have told her to wear longer skirts than normal, so viewers don't see too much of her cha-cha-cha. Rachel, who would be your dream contestant?
On Countdown, probably Ryan Gosling.
What makes you think he'd be very good at sums?
Who said he'd be good at the sums?
Rachel graduated from Oxford University with a master's degree in mathematics covering quantum theory, fluid mechanics and applied maths, the perfect preparation for spending day after day multiplying 25 by 4. Were you a child genius in the 80s?
I started school when I was two.
Yeah, you started school when you were two?
Yeah, I was really, really annoying, so my mum just got rid of me as quickly as she could.
How old were you in the 80s?
I was born in 86.
And you started school in 88?
89.
Well, that's three. It's basic maths.
Ten vain.
Three. In 89.
Rachel joined Countdown in 2009, aged 22, replacing Carol Vorderman. Yes, Carol Vorderman, we're talking about you. You used to be on the television. On Countdown. That's right, with the numbers. Well, she's fallen back
well
to sleep.
Well done making it to January.
Rachel, after all the glamour and glitz of Strictly, how does it feel to be back on Catsdale's Countdown?
Well, it's not. It was a really scary experience having to dance in front of 10 million people, so it's quite nice being the so-called expert on something.
How do I compare to Brucey out of interest as a host?
Well, you're both very nice, very smartly dressed, funny. You both do the little hop thing when you come on. Neither of you's got your own teeth.
was really brainy at school. She got more A's than a scouser trying to break up a fight. Rachel, you're a big Manchester United fan. What's more tense and exciting, watching Man U play or watching these guys play Countdown?
There's just no comparison. This is more like, I used to play Sunday League football and sometimes they had a beer at half-time. This kind of feels more like that.
Sorry. You used to play Sunday League football?
Yeah.
And used to have a pint at half-time?
We didn't do very well.
It sounds like, I mean, I've never really been interested in going to see the football before, but...
Yeah.
Now...
It was a less...
If you're interested in getting into football, you should go and watch Man United this year. It's really funny, they're shit.
What's the biggest difference between regular Countdown and Cats Does Countdown?
Well, people aren't really ashamed to be on here, because before Josh came out, he was really excited backstage about coming on Countdown.
So I'm still excited now. Don't act like I'm acting all cool.
When you say I'm really excited to Rachel, if you could not point at your dick, that'd be cool. That'd just be terrific. In 2012, Rachel took part in Celebrity Mastermind. There were three passes, two from John Humphreys and one from one of the camera guys. Rachel, are you intimidated by Dara? He's something of a maths genius.
It's not intimidating. I mean, not many people at parties want to talk about maths, but Dara, oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, two math geeks at a party.
Oh,
it's going off. In 2009, Rachel was recruited by the Post Office to advise holiday makers how to make the most from their holiday currency in an initiative called Someone at the Post Office Wants to Meet Rachel Riley. Now, maths. Why bother, Rachel?
Well, it's the only truly universal language, isn't it?
The only truly universal... What about love? Yeah. English.
Well, you need it for when you're going shopping or you're doing your finances or your taxes.
Rachel obtained A-levels in maths and further maths. The one kid that did that in my school was a victim of bullying and further bullying. Rachel, have you got any tricks of the trade for the numbers game?
There are loads, actually. I go into schools and play games with kids and teach them. My favourite one is if you add up the digits of any number and then that number's divisible by 9, then the first number's divisible by 9. That's a good one.
Well, hang on, you've got to say that slowly. Go on, if you...
You add up the digits of any number...
Right.
And then you get that number. If that number is divisible by 9, then the first number is.
Oh, I shouldn't have come back, should I? The game hasn't even started. The game hasn't started and I'm out of my depth.
Rachel Riley took over from Carol Vorderman in much the same way as in the wild a young male silverback gorilla will attack and drive out the older male when the older male starts asking for too much money. You've had a break from the show. How do you keep up your math skills? What do you do?
Well, off the back of the success of Cats Does Countdown, we actually, Susie and I, do another show called Countdown. it's really similar.
When's it on?
It's on every weekday, 2:40, Channel 4.
2:40 in the day?
2:40 in the day, yeah.
Who would watch something at 2:40 in the day? Sounds like the kind of thing for, like, the long-term unemployed and pensioners.
John Richardson watches it most days.
I Sky Plus it, actually. I'm in the gym at 2:40, pumping iron.
Rachel is a mathematician with a background in quantum theory, fluid mechanics, and a remarkable aptitude for mental arithmetic, which is all well and good, but can you do this? Come on, with your maths degree, come on.
Is that it?
Strangely arousing. Rachel, how do I compare to Nick Hewer as a host of this show?
Well, Nick's kind of got his own catchphrases now, and you don't really have any, so he kind of...
What's his catchphrase?
Like, be sure of it. When Susie does her Origin of Words, he talks about her special spot. And whenever...
Be sure of your special spot.
When it's my numbers game, he tells the contestants it's time for them to enter my area.
He's a disgrace. OK. Seems like Rachel's everywhere these days. She's on Countdown, The Gadget Show, Strictly Come Dancing, My Dreams at Night, My Thoughts When I'm Having a Shower. She's absolutely bloody everywhere. Rachel, you get a lot of fan mail. What's the weirdest thing you've been sent?
I got a letter once from a guy who was called Dean, a.k.a. Dean. He sent
me... my name's Dean, but people call me Dean.
He sent me a whole load of design drawings for our clothing business with like structure of financial payment for me. I was going to get 5% of anything we made. And he also offered me between £50 and £20,000 in postal orders for sex, but only if I got a 3G phone.
And was that the deal breaker? Now, the dress this evening, you can write on your dress.
Yeah, they can do numbers. Or like, you can have fun and do that. Like...
Is this?
It's like an anti.
It's rather fun. With her short dresses and long legs, the only thing that's been responsible for more premature deaths among Countdown viewers is a winter cold snap. Rachel, who's your idol in the world of maths?
Probably there's a guy called Schrödinger. You might have heard of his cat. He was pretty good. He did stuff in the world of quantum. And he was German. He didn't like the Nazis, so he moved to England, to Oxford, and then he...
Is he the one who put a dead cat in a box and then said, is it dead?
Oh, no. Well, it's both dead and alive at the same time.
Yeah, at the same time.
That was him.
He was a Fruit Loop, wasn't he?
Also, just open the box and have a look.
Well, then it is dead or alive, but before you look, it's both dead and alive at the same time in the quantum world.
Oh, is the quantum world in Germany or England? I'm unsure now.
It's in Alton Towers.
Can I ask, is Schrödinger dead?
Yeah.
Is he in a coffin?